Okay, so, we can't really tell the condition of this hardwood because of the glue from the old glue-down carpet. So until we get the drum sander in here and cut through all this, we won't know how many boards we need to replace in here. But I assume this room's gonna be in pretty good condition. The hallway, also gonna be hard to tell until we get the drum sander in. Still a lot of glue from the old glue-down carpet here. But you definitely, I can see more delamination here. I can see that the wood filler between each individual board is lost going from bedroom to bedroom and out of the bathroom. So I would assume we're gonna have to replace all of that from bedroom door to bedroom door all the way to that back wall. But again, we won't really know until we get a sander. Now I'm actually gonna run through with a belt sander and a super heavy grit, see if I can cut through this before I rent the drum sander to finish the job. Just because, you know, when I have the drum sander here, it costs me money every hour. So if I can rip through this with a belt sander and kind of assess how many of these boards need to be replaced, that'd be nice. Definitely we'll need to replace things like this. Let's see if I can get it to focus. Big chunk missing out of this board. Okay. Big chunk missing out of this board. All right, this bedroom is in pretty good shape other than the entryway. There are some 10 penny nails or some framing nails, whatever you want to call them. Large head nails here. I have yet to rip apart an old house and not find these as a repair somewhere along the line. So these large nail heads here, kind of all throughout here. They're really a pain to get out without ripping apart these boards that are being held. But I'm gonna try, and worst case scenario, if I can't get them out, I'm just going to replace these whole boards with new, but there will be a color difference when you do that, so I try to do that as little as possible in the middle of the room. Outside of that, this room is in pretty good shape. Closets tend to always be in pretty good shape. This room is in pretty good shape as well, except for the center here. A few boards that are in pretty rough condition. That again have a lot of these large head nails holding them in. So we'll see how many of those we have to replace. Is definitely, I mean, I bought 100 square feet of this wood to be able to patch out. And if I have to use all of it, that's fine. It'd be pretty absurd if I had to use all of it, considering 100 square feet is probably 20% of this entire house, the hardwood in this house. So hopefully I just have to use, you know, 20 feet or so. I can save the rest for when I refinish some of my other properties in this area. We got some rot here. The bathtub is on the other side of this wall here. And it looks like some moisture was getting in at some point. So I'll have to cut out the ends of these pieces and patch in. No big deal though. And other than that, just a lot of paint in this room. Closet's in pretty good shape. Okay. So yeah, the big question here is what's underneath all of this. So I'm gonna actually start ripping through some of this with a belt sander, see if that's effective at all. If not, I'll just be renting the drum sander twice. One day to strip through all this carpet glue, and then another day to actually do the refinishing once I patch in whatever needs to be replaced, once I can see it, once the drum sander cuts through all this black stuff. So
well, I I was in the land of cotton. Old times, they are not forgotten. Look away, look away, look away, Dixieland.
Alright, so this is the condition of the floor now. I pulled all the nails, all the staples, everything that was kind of going to mess up the sander when I come through here. This room, again, it's just going to not really... I'm not going to know what I'm into in this room until I start sanding. So it looks like it's going to be okay in the big span of the room. There looks like there's some staining. Where was it? Right there. Looks like there's some staining in front of this window, like moisture was getting in. Kind of hard to see on the camera, but these boards look significantly grayer than the other boards. And also you see this big delamination here. So we'll see how that cleans up when we sand. And then in the hallway here, we did some patchwork. I didn't do too much, so when I sand through some of this, I may wind up having to do more. This is pretty much just patching the pieces that were splintering, broken apart, had big holes, or huge nails. In this room, I was able to pull the nails without patching anything out. There is, looks like, large stains here, so we'll see how those, how deep those are when we start sanding. These boards in the hallway, unfortunately, will probably be pretty noticeable even after the refinish. Noticeable that they're new. And then in this room, you had to patch some there and patch out those rotten boards on the edge. Again, they're going to be noticeable. You're going to see lighter wood, and the grain pattern on this oak is going to be significantly different than on the older oak, because this is from younger trees, whereas this other oak is tighter grain. That's much much heavier grain, wilder grain, but anyways, we're gonna start sanding. I'm gonna go grab the sander from Home Depot and we'll see what we're into.
There's a place where the sun doth shine and the birds keep time with the pines up yonder. That's the home of my Caroline. She's dancing in the sky. How sweet when we meet on the golden streets of the great white valley. These old chains around my feet, they're pulling me back down. Caroline, oh Caroline, I'll be home just any old time. The grave in the garden will be satisfied till your name's next to mine. My bones do break and my hands do shake as I lie in the wake of time's cruel slaughter. But if I die before I wake, I'm gonna see my Caroline. Caroline, oh Caroline, I'll be home just any old time. The grave in the garden will be satisfied till your name's next to mine. There's a place where the sun doth shine and the birds keep time with the pines up yonder. That's the home of my Caroline. She's dancing in the sky. Caroline, oh Caroline, I'll be home just any old time. The grave in the garden will be satisfied till your name's next to mine. Caroline, my Caroline, I'll be home just any old time. The grave and the garden will be satisfied until your name is next to mine.
Thank you.
as they are, and keep your clothes on. I've had more than my fill of whiskey and women and good-hearted villains, but there's a wickedness in me still. Keep that gun locked away, boy. Well, you know you're an angry young man. Going in town with six rounds, you're sure to be hellbound. That house you got's built on the sand. I've been living on the sand. Don't take much to guide my hand. Far from promised land, on the sand. At that bottle, you'll claim that Jesus turned the water to wine. You'll be wishing that wine you were drinking was water when you're jumping the bridge in the night. Forgive me, don't it sound more clear when I'm screaming it day after day? I've lost all my patience, I'm wasted on waiting on making my next mistake. I've been living on the sand. Don't take much to guide my hand. Far from promised land, on the sand. I've been living on the sand. Don't take much to guide my hand. Far from promised land, on the sand. Degree. And all the folks around town swore to lay me in the ground. They found out I put that poor boy down. You see, I did not much care for the way that he'd sit and glare. So I closed his eyes for good with a barroom chair.
West, Appalachian stone. Far beneath that cold ground, all alone, oh, but if you're asking me, where I would rather be, it was worth it to see that boy cut from the knees.
Temptation, sorrow and solitude, these are the precious things, the only words that are worth remembering.
Thank you.
Reverend, Reverend, please come quick. Cause I got something to admit. I met a man out in the sticks, a good old miss. He drove a Series 10 Cadillac and wore a cigar on his lip. Don't you know the devil wears a suit and tie? Saw him driving down the 61 in early July, white as a cotton, feeling sharp as a knife. I heard him howling as he passed me by. And he said, I know you, young man. I know you by the state of your hands. You're a six-string picker, just as I am. Let me learn you some, I know a few turns to make all the girls dance. Don't you know the devil wears a suit and tie? I saw him driving down the 61 in early July, white as a cotton, feeling sharp as a knife. I heard him howling as he passed.